Hi guys, today we're going to see how you can move your WordPress website to a new host. Let's say you have a WordPress site and you're not happy with the current hosting provider. Now how do you move the site from your current hosting provider to a new host? You can do that by watching this video. So after watching this video, you will be able to move your entire WordPress site to a new host without affecting any of your website's content. Okay. So let's get started. I'm Brian from Website Learners, and let's move our WordPress website. First, let's see the website which we are going to move. Here it is.
Now this is the site which we are going to move to the new host. You can see all the pages and its content. Now before we move the site to the new host, let's see where our site is hosted right now. So to check that, just go to the video you're watching right now and then click this link and it will take you to this page. This is the page where you can find your current hosting provider. So on this page, you can find the hosting of any site. So to find the hosting of your site, enter your website's URL in this field. So let's go to our site and copy this URL. And paste it here. Now if we click find hosting, you can see where the site is hosted right now. And as you can see, our site is now hosted on GoDaddy.
So now that you know your current hosting provider, now how do you move the site to a new host? So to move your site to a new host, we are going to do three steps. The first step is to get your new hosting. Now there are many hosting providers available on the internet. I'm going to choose WebSpaceKit hosting and move my site there. So to get your new hosting on WebSpaceKit, just click the link below this video
and it will take you to WebSpaceKit. So this is the website where we are going to get our new hosting. Now go to plans and here you can see we have four different plans. Now if you want to move one website, you can select this plan. Or if you want to move multiple websites, you can select these plans. As I want to move one website to this new host, I am going to select this plan. Here it will ask you to choose a domain. As you can see here, we already have a domain on our current site. So as we already have a domain and want to use the current domain for the new host, I'm going to select this. And here, you need to enter the same domain name, which is here. So let's enter that. Now once you've entered your domain name, to get the new hosting, click Use. Now here you can see that we're getting our hosting for 12 months. So to get it, click Continue. And then fill up these details. And here, you need to choose your payment method. I'm going to use my card. So let's enter our details here. And then click Order Now. As you can see, we have successfully placed our order. Now let's click here. And you can see here, we have successfully got our new hosting. Once you have purchased your new hosting, WebSpaceKit automatically installs WordPress. Okay, once you've got your new hosting, you can go to step 2, which is to copy your WordPress site to the new host. So to copy the site to the new host, you need to first log into your website. So to log in, let's go to our website. And then enter /wp-admin next to your website's address and press enter. And now it will take you to the login page of WordPress. Now just log in to your site. Okay, so now we have logged into our WordPress site, which is on our old host. Once you have logged in, now to copy your website, you need to install a plugin on this WordPress site. So to install the plugin, let's go to Plugins and then click Add New. Now search for a plugin called Migrate Guru. And you will get this plugin. So this is the plugin which is going to help us copy the WordPress site to the new hosting. Now to install this plugin, let's click Install. And then click Activate. Okay, so now we've successfully installed the plugin. Once you have installed the plugin, we need to copy the site to our new host. So to copy your site to the new host, just enter your email address here. And then click Migrate Site. And it will take you to this page, where it will ask you to choose your new hosting provider. Based on your hosting, you can select the method. Since WebSpaceKit has cPanel access, I'm going to choose this one. So let's click on it. Now to move your site to your new host, it will ask you to enter these details. Now once you have purchased your new hosting, you should have received these details in your email. So let's go to our inbox. And you can see that we have got this email. Just open it. And you can see we have these details here. Just copy these details and paste them on your site. So first, let's copy the site's URL and paste it here. Then copy this IP address and paste it here. Next, we need to enter the cPanel login details. So let's copy this username and paste it here. Then copy this password and paste it here. Once you have entered these details, we can now start to copy our site to the new host. Now before you start copying your site, you need to check if your new host has SSL. As you can see, we have got free SSL for the plan we selected. So if your new host has SSL, make sure that you enter HTTPS here. Okay, once you have entered these details, you can now start copying your site to the new host. So to copy your site, all you have to do is click Migrate. As soon as you click it, you can see that your website is getting copied to the new host. And once it's done, you will see this page, which means your site is now successfully copied to your new host. Okay, now we have successfully copied our site to the new host. To check if your site is moved to the new host, let's go back to the Hosting Finder tool. And now if we click Find Hosting, you can see that our site is still hosted on GoDaddy, which is our old host. So this means our site is not yet moved to the new host. Now we've copied all the files from our old host to the new host. But our domain still points to the old host and loads our site from there. Now in order to load our site from the new host, we need to point our domain to the new host. So to point our domain to the new host, we need to add the IP address of the new host to our domain. Next, let's go to the final step, which is to add the new IP address to our domain. So to get the IP address of the new host, let's go back to our inbox. Here you can see, we have the new IP address. So this is the IP address which you need to add to your domain. Since our domain is with GoDaddy, let's go to GoDaddy and click sign in. Now let's enter our GoDaddy account details and then click sign in. Now here you will find the domain of your website. Now to add the new IP address to this domain, click DNS and here you can see these details. Now you need to add the IP address to your AA record. So here you can see that we have the IP address of the old host. To change this to the WebSpaceKit IP address, click here. Now before you change the IP address, make a note of this old IP address so that you can use it in case you want to go back to your old host. Now I'm going to copy this and save it to my notepad. Okay, once you have saved the old IP address, let's go back to our inbox. So to add the IP address of the new host, let's delete this and then copy this new IP address and paste it here. Now if you click save, your new IP address will be added to your domain. Now if you have multiple A records on the same IP address, you need to add the IP address for all those A records. So like we did before, let's click here and delete this. Now paste the new IP address which we copied earlier and then click save. So now we have successfully added the IP address to our domain and our site will be moved to the new host. So to check that, let's go back to Hosting Finder. You can see that previously our site was hosted on GoDaddy. Now if you click Find Hosting, you can see that your website is now hosted on WebSpaceKit. So this means we have successfully moved our site from the old host to the new host. Now if we open a new tab and go to our site, you can see that it has the same content which we had before.
So now we have successfully moved our site to a new host. You can use the same method for moving your site to any host. Okay, next, let's go to the last part of this video, which is to activate SSL on your website. Now if you go to our site, you can see that we do not have the HTTPS or the SSL lock symbol here. Now as we have free SSL on our hosting plan, the SSL will be automatically activated after a few hours on your site. But if you don't want to wait for the automatic SSL and want to enable it immediately, you have an option to activate it manually. So to activate SSL immediately on your site, let's go to WebSpaceKit.
Now click here, then click cPanel and it will take you to this page. Now here, search for SSL, then click this and you will get this page. Now to activate SSL, click here, then click here. So now the SSL will be activated on our site. Now if we go back to our site and click refresh, you can see that our site is now secure with SSL.
Okay, so that's it guys. This is how you can move your website to a new host. Once you move your site to the new host, make sure you check all the pages and see if everything loads perfectly. If everything is working fine, then you can stop the subscription of the old host. Now, if you're finding any issues with your site and want to revert back to the old host, just enter your old IP address, which you have saved on your notepad, into the domain's DNS page. Now, to start migrating your site to WebSpaceKit, click the link below this video. You can see that it has a lot of great features, which you can check out here. And also make sure you subscribe to Website Learners to get more videos like this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.